Welcome back to Let's Play Tacoma. Blind, I'm the RPG chick. There are frame rate hits. I did say we're going to go to engineering at the end of last episode, but I just remember there's a few things that I did not unlock. Oh, I got disoriented there. I'm like, what? Cryogenics. Right. Docking is that way, so we want to go this way. Oh, there's a basketball. This can be really disorienting. Biomedical. Because I pretty much know... I'm pretty sure I know what... Sarah's graduation date is most probably the way into the scan results. Scanner code. So, yeah. Don't look down, you get frame rate hits. And there's a few other things. This Clive's locker is Evie's office. I keep pressing the button for sprint. No, there is no sprint in this game. So there's nothing to... It's weird how that happens, isn't it? There's nothing to assign it to. Her office, right? No, I don't need that. So we have this. Yeah. The bioscan record pin reminder phrase graduation. So you look here. They make it just too easy. I mean, anyone can hack into her stuff. Or, well, it's not really hacking into, it's just figuring out the right code. There's really no hacking involved. That's one of the things I hate, I dislike about society today, is that someone will leave their social media site open on the computer, you know, and somebody will flick on the monitor, see it on, and go, right, hacked on their... No, you didn't do anything. If anything, you figured out their code, you know, was the name of their dog, you know, or something like that. So, where... License issue date... Is it... the incident. So, I guess I was thinking it maybe was her license issue date. 02-04-2082, so let's go. See, I guess I'll just plain try the... Is this where it is? No. I know that's not it, I just felt like washing my hands. That is... okay. 2082. No? That's when it was issued, her license. O282? I mean, we're assuming that 0282. Well, that's a little too close. I can't pick that up. Except that maybe it's in her... So who plays first?
Alright, good speed.
Oh, Odin. Did I do the right thing?
It's in what regard?
It's not her turn.
Deserved.
In what
thing?
In what regard?
Yeah, her thing is here. All right. I guess I gotta look for it. I thought I saw her graduation date there.
Oh, Odin. Did I do the...
So I'll be back. John Hopkins University School of Medicine. 2080. May. 16th. May 16th, 2080. So first I'm just gonna try 2080. I keep going here for some reason. Ah, nice. Okay, well, let's check out Roberta. All smileys. So she's 28 years old. Yeah, height 162 centimeters. Weight is 91.1 kilos. I don't even think in those measurements. Blood pressure is 140 over 90, which I think is pretty good. Standard immuno antiviral schedule AC. Addictive substance resistance 4. Anti-carcinogenic filter series A. Yeah, just testing for all these things. Sanger. Menstrual suppression. Blood type tailoring. Global allergen filter. UNAC standard. Telomere degeneration filter Omega. Vision and hearing schedule. Cryogenic stasis risk factors none. Stasis viability analysis. Patient exhibits no physical symptoms that might lead to injury or death following cryogenic stasis or revival. Physicians should proceed with cryogenic procedures as appropriate. For medical staff eyes only. This is who? Natalie? Yep. She's 24 years old. Ooh. She's got a heart murmur. Probable mitral stenosis. Patient exhibits clear signs of cardiovascular abnormality, heart murmur. This condition represents severe risk of death during the cryogenic revival process. Expected probability of survival for the patient under this treatment is 18%. Oh my god. Patient is not recommended for cryogenic stasis. Physicians should consider alternative methods of treatment for this patient. So she's probably the last one you'd want to put in, you know, if you're running out of air and stuff. She's the last person you'd want to go into stasis. I mean, so far everyone else could go in. And, what's his name? Not David. Andrew. He is 42 years old. He has filtering stuff. No physical symptoms that might lead to injury, death, blah, blah, blah. So he's good. She has a problem, Natalie. So. Oh, yeah, now I see the sad face. How sad. Made me feel sad just seeing the sad face. Okay. I can't even exit out of it. Don't you be watching me like that. So I'll see you guys at another area. We're gonna find our way into some more places. Okay, I'm in Evie's personal quarters. Sylvia Plath, the bell jar. If you turn this over. I've been looking at everything in here. 1228. I'm thinking that's the code for her. Her inner office? I don't know. This is more like a conference room? I don't know. 1228, just saying so I forget. Administrator's office, alright. Yay! I don't think I looked on the other side of that book, so that would explain why. So we got stuff. We got a lot of papers that we cannot read. Got this thing. I always try them just to see how they work and to see if there's, you never know, there might be a note pinned on it. Orbital Workers Board, Bureau of Certification Board, Bureau of Training, Certificate of Qualification presented to Evelyn Victoria St. James. This worker is hereby certified for orbital postings of up to 24 consecutive months. Okay. Some hours in microgravity or something. We got that. So wrong, I know. That made a sound of opening and it did not open. Yeah. Oh, who's that then? Union Gala 2082 Employee Awards. First Nations Manufacturers Union Cascadia. Let's put this here. We might figure out who that is. And stop. Can't look at any of that stuff. Okay. What about any of this stuff? Nope, not really. Dear Mom, I was looking through some of Karen's things, and I thought I'd write you. I hope you've been doing all right these days. It's still really hard for me. I've been trying to find meaning in my work up here, but I still have such trouble connecting with people. I wonder what was scribbled out. Since something. Isn't she, like, supposed to be leading everybody? More or less? And she's... This is just qualification for orbital postings. Alright, so yeah, we're gonna open this. Oops. Mature spell? Yeah. Decommissioned. Status alert. The following orbital conditions warning is in effect from 5 p.m. to 10 p.m. something time. The station's orbit will collide with a field of increased asteroid activity and orbital debris. Impact preparedness level will be increased from green to yellow during this time. Crew should continue with normal operations, but data lost. From Venturis Operational Logistics. Station Administrator St. James, upon review, your request for network specialist access to the Odin unit's operational hardware has been summarily denied. We refer you to Corporate Regulation Article VT stuff, which clearly restricts all access to AI hardware from contracting crew. As this is the third time a request of this nature has been made by Tacoma under your supervision, your contractor dossier has been marked with an additional disciplinary flag, totaling 2 on your account. Please remember that one more disciplinary flag will trigger an overall contractor viability review. Ventures. That's why she didn't want to help Natalie get to the AI. don't put me in the middle of it, she said. Remember that conversation? Yep, yep. Very, very understandable. So here's her stuff. So she actually looks like when she's not an AR hologram? Avatar, whatever. Shoot in Vancouver. Stuff. Date of birth. 2035. How old is everyone going to be when she's born? Okay, so that's that. There's not a whole hell of a lot here. I dropped that. Is that her sister, maybe? Karen's stuff. I don't know who that is. In any case, that's it. I don't see anything else. What's that? Sergio Venturi?
Gene filter, augmented reality, artificial consciousness. And yet, Venturis had not been a part of these... Venturis, prior to my appointment as CEO by the Board of Trustees, Venturis had not been led by a Venturi for over four decades. And those were decades that saw an unprecedented wave of advancement outside our walls. Gene filtering, augmented reality, artificial consciousness. And yet, Venturis had not been a part of these new technologies. With your help, all of that is about to change. The technology to fully automate isolated orbital facilities using AI has existed for as long as I've been alive. Venturis must lead the way on this crucial issue. Humans. For jobs only humans can do. Cutting-edge, multi-generation artificial intelligence safely handling the rest. Orbital safety above all else. Would this significantly reduce the number of people working full-time in space? Yes. And that's just the point.
This has been a message from your Chief Executive Officer, Sergio Venturi.
This is probably just going to be music through the rest. What was that? Oh, that was the crash. Oh, we can hear her in here. That's right, I forgot she walked in here. Come on in. Make yourself at home. Who's that? Who's this? You don't know? Sure you don't know? She's looking at the... She was looking at it. Yeah, it's not so soothing anymore, is it? She just put it back. Oh, she took it out. She's looking at it. So then why was it still in the drawer when I got there? Well, obviously, yeah, she went back and put it back. This is... Days transpired... Yeah, that's bothersome. Days transpired in between, so... I want to get her info. See if I can find out who this woman is. Nah, there's nothing here. Yeah, I don't know who that is. We might find out later. Now I want to check out Clive's That goes back up. He's in operations, I think. So, there's not only... Not only is there a key to a locker kind of thing under his bed, a drawer under his bed. But his is the only locker we can't get into. So I'm going to figure out this code. Who knows, maybe the key is inside. I don't think I even looked at this, which would explain why I never got the locker code. Maybe I don't think I noticed what these things were at first. Notes to self. Call mother. Evie's birthday coming up. Gym locker. 1407. So, I'm just going to write this down because I'm going to be reading other things and I'm going to forget. 1407. So, send request Evie special cat food. Oh yeah. Don't slack off in gym. Search AR tutorial cake decoration. That's the same ad as before. It should... These windows should appear over on the windows when you open them. So I'm just saying. From Venturis Contractor Relations Account. Digits. Re-Venturis Belt Operations Team Transfer Request. I would be honored to join your team. So this is their response to his message. Contractor Siddiqui, we have received your inquiries about your application for position Venturis Belt Timeshare Sales Coordinator. As noted in our prior message, your materials are under review and will be considered along with all other applicants for this position. We will contact you with any further updates as necessary. Venturis Contractor Relations, yeah, Venturis Orbital Command, Fountain of Paradise Spaceport, Low Orbit, Singapore. And that's his info. He's very tall, I notice, and holds himself like he's in a worried state of mind when you walk, when you see him walk around and stuff, just his body language. Very well done. Clive Rowling Siddiqui. So issued in London. Stuff. Yeah. So, yeah, I wrote that down, so... You know, I'm pretty sure there might be one of these desktops that I missed then. Because... I'm not sure. I'll have to go around and check those. That's his personal quarters. We will go there next. It's the office I just came from. Huh. Lockers. So I wrote 1407. Nice. Fitness program, intermediate 1. Caloric intake custom plan. Last activity was 9 days ago. Oh, that's him. College peak statistics. Yeah. 7 minute mile. Come on, Clive. You guys can read that. I hate these floppy things. There's avocado shampoo. Gum. Key! Bunk drawer! Alright, let's put this... there. I can't carry it in inventory, so comb. Anything else I can carry? No. Is there something back there? No, that's okay. So that's it, really. Just a key and a few things. Nice! My first time holding a physical key. That's crazy. Sorry, good old chap. I'm gonna have to... Cool. Whatever it is, gotta be something you know, that he doesn't access that often. Something he really wants under wraps, because the key is all the way in his locker. So he's going to walk there, get the key, come back just to get in this place. Letter. We've got a letter. That says, Clive R. Siddiqui at Lunar Transfer Station, Tacoma. Oh, that's an actual address. That's crazy. EL Luggage Point 1, 1 Venturis Orbit. Do we have a light? Can we see better? I guess. I don't know how much that helps. Dear Mother, I write to congratulate you on your recent appointment to the Advisory Council of the Tate 20th Century. Your prestigious career in the arts has always been a constant inspiration to me. To that end, I have continued exploring advancement both within Venturis and without. When I left Hilton after graduating at Hilton U, I was so excited for the possibilities at Carnival, but as you told me then, foregoing company loyalty for fickle opportunity is a fraught path. I have been working to claw my way back up ever since. Trust, at least, that I am trying my best every day. I promise to tell you more about Evelyn Victoria. She is the administrator of this station, and her wit and candor keep me constantly on my toes. And for what it's worth, I am deeply in love. Really? I dare say she might well meet your approval. Perhaps on our next shore leave, a visit to the family estate is in order. With all my love, Clive. Well, yeah, we figured something was going on because they went in together. That's a heavy letter. Darling, I found these on shore leave in a quaint Brighton market stall. They brought to mind the color of your chestnut eyes, stupid Clive. I guess it wasn't reciprocated. Aw. So that's... Wait. Is that why he's drinking himself into a stupor? Yeah, this is some real personal stuff here. I'm just so wrong for doing this, aren't I? What? I took the whole lock off of it. I took the whole lock off. Alright. Now, yeah, as far as I know, these are all the places that we haven't seen. The only other place requiring a physical lock, or key rather, was in medical. Where the prescription medication was being kept. So, I haven't seen anything like that, and I don't see a reason to want to go into and check out the medication. I mean, we don't need it, right? I mean, if we can check it out, we will, but we'll see. Thanks so much for watching, guys. Yeah, see you next time, and we actually, now, this time for real, go on to engineering. Thanks again. See you next time, and always seek adventure.